VR review of the Audi R8 LMS. This is great. There's a lot of room in here. There's a bit of clipping. Well, not even clipping. There's just a little bar across the top of my head there. But I'm sitting low enough that it doesn't bother me. I'm not sitting too far back. It's got a lovely cut-out steering wheel, so you can see that dash all of the time. There's a rearview mirror that's in a beautiful spot up there. However, this car has that for a rear view, for a rear window. So no matter how much you move, you're not going to be able to see a lot out of that. The side mirrors are small. They're not too bad, but they don't give you full view all the way around your car. So virtual mirror, luckily there's just a lot of black space up there where the dash ends, where the windscreen ends. So plenty of room for that up there, and it's inobtrusive. Your relative or whatever other settings, your black box, has plenty of room up on the dash away from this large air vent, and not yet cutting into the 3D world beyond. So yeah, really easy spot to put that. It's a nice open cabin, good visibility. You can adjust your height quite a bit without starting to run into problems. At sort of 8 centimeters, I'd sort of stop because the top of that ceiling might be a problem. But you know, at 6.5, you're nice and high. You can see a long way down the road. The wheel's not too low in your lap. Really clear view of that dash there. This is great in VR. Nitpicks, that's a little bit low res down there. Bit of color banding. I'd prefer that to be low res rather than slow down my whole game because there's a super high def bloody whatever sitting over there. Let's knock it back into first and do a little bit of driving, see what it's like when moving. Now that relative has crept up a little bit too high. It's floating, easier to see in VR, of course, than in the view that you're getting. But if I just move it down slightly, it won't be quite so distracting and away from the dash. So I can, unobstructed view down the whole side of the dash, the windscreen there. And on left corners, pretty big pillar, but there's no netting, so I can see out the left window there, which is a lot better than those cars with the big black mesh that hides your view. Just open up down this back straight. Yeah, shift lights are easy to see, obviously. Love cars with these cut-out steering wheels. And spot your apex, even though I can't hit it, through that really big, clear, unobstructed windscreen. So yeah, this is a great car in VR. The only downside is physical limitations of the car. Yes, you can't see out the back, but that's why we have a virtual mirror that you can pop up there. It's not in the way. Yeah, great in VR.